Thanks for purchasing SIMMs from MacConnection. We've included this video and installation guide to assist those of you who prefer to install the memory yourself. As with any installation, there's always the possibility that you may damage your computer. If you don't feel comfortable with the procedure after you've watched the tape and read the installation guide, have the SIMMs installed by an authorized Apple dealer. Please read the following notice carefully before you go on. This tape includes instructions for a number of SIMM-based Macintosh products. Here's a brief listing of all the models we'll show you. We'll start with the closed architecture Macs, the Mac Plus, the Mac Classic, the Mac SE, and the SE30. The next section will cover the Mac 2, the Mac 2X, and the Mac 2FX. Then we'll show you the Mac 2CX, the Mac 2CI, the Mac 2SI, the Mac LC, and the LaserWriter NTX. Finally, we'll show you how to upgrade the Mac Portable, even though it's not a SIMM-based computer. Before you get started, here's some advice that pertains to all Macs. Always touch a grounded object, like the metal frame of the Mac, before you handle any computer components. This will discharge any static electricity that is built up in your clothing or body without damaging the computer. Touching the plastic part of the computer won't work. Since even a small static discharge can damage an integrated circuit, we also recommend touching the metal frame anytime you return from an interruption in the installation procedure. As a further precaution, we encourage you to leave your SIMMs in the static-free bags we ship them in until you're actually ready to install them. When you finally do remove the SIMMs, always handle them by the circuit board. Avoid touching the solder edge or the chips, since they're both sensitive to skin oils. And if you purchase the 2 or 4 megabyte SIMMs, you'll need to purchase and install System 7.0 so that your Macintosh will recognize the increased memory these chips provide. Working with SIMMs is simple. Here's a picture of a SIMM installed in an SE. It's held at an angle just like in a Plus. Other Macs hold the SIMMs straight up like this. Either way, the SIMM sockets work the same. These two clips on either side of the socket hold the SIMM in place, and these two pegs fit into holes on either side of the SIMM to keep it aligned correctly. Here's how to remove a SIMM. Use your thumbs to spread the clips apart. Bend them just far enough to clear the edge of the board. If you bend them too far, they'll break off. Once they've cleared the edge, bring the top of the SIMM forward with your index fingers and pull the SIMM out of the socket. Installing a SIMM is even easier. First, insert the solder edge into the socket. Make sure it's straight and is all the way down. Then push the top back into the socket until the clips snap over the circuit board. If it's in right, you'll notice that the pegs fit into the holes in the SIMM. It's that simple. Of course, getting at the SIMM sockets to perform this simple procedure is a little tricky, and it's different for each model. That's why we made this video, and here's how it's organized. We've marked each section of the tape with an identifying graphic, so all you have to do is fast forward to the one that indicates the type of computer you're working on. First, you'll see an introductory graphic that looks like one of these. One is for the closed architecture Macs, and the other is for the open architecture Macs. If you have one of the computers listed, you should watch the introductory remarks that follow. Then fast forward until you see the graphic that refers to your specific Mac. It'll look like this. Watch whatever follows. If you're installing SIMMs in a LaserWriter or a portable, there are no introductory remarks, so you can go directly to the appropriately marked section. Before you start your installation, watch the tape and read our printed instructions. If you have a question, give us a call at 800-334-4444 and ask for Mac technical support. Now we're ready to open up your Mac and install the SIMMs. While I go get some assistance to help with the real work, you can fast forward to the section that applies to your Mac. They'll appear in this order. The first thing you'll need to do is remove the case. This is an SE, but the procedure is pretty much the same for the Classic, the Plus, and the SE30. You'll need a number 15 Torx wrench or 3/32 Allen wrench and a case cracker. You may also need a straight blade screwdriver if you have an SE with a reset interrupt switch installed. Well, I'll get you started. Remove the keyboard, mouse, power cords, and any other peripheral cables from your Mac. At this point, I could use some assistance, so here's someone to show you how it's done.
First, lay the Mac down on a soft surface like your mouse pad. This Mac has the reset interrupt switch installed, so we'll pry that out with a screwdriver. Next, remove the four screws that hold the case to the front facade. Two are next to the ports, and two more are in the handle. I've taken these out already. If you have a Mac Plus, you'll also have another one hiding behind the battery door that needs to be removed. Once the screws are out, insert the case cracker in this seam and squeeze it slightly to pry the case away from the front facade. Don't try to do it with one squeeze. Use it in several places around the seam until the case is loose. Pull the case up and away from the facade. The loose piece of foil you see over the ports is called the RF shield. Take it off as well. Now stop and take a look inside. Here's the floppy drive, the hard disk drive, the motherboard, and the picture tube, also known as the CRT. Be extremely careful working around the CRT. It's a very fragile vacuum tube. And if it's bumped, it could crack or implode, sending glass flying dangerously in every direction. The most common way of damaging the CRT is by putting too much pressure on this video card. Our advice is to avoid touching it. A damaged CRT cannot be fixed except by complete replacement, and that's costly. Also, avoid touching this protective suction cup on the CRT. Underneath is the anode, and it can hold an electrical charge even after the Mac has been turned off.
Now you're ready to install SIMMs in your computer. Just fast forward to the appropriate graphic and watch our technical experts walk you through the procedures. Remember, if you have a question, give us a call at 800-334-4444 and ask for Mac technical support.
You should already have the case off your Plus. Touch the metal frame to discharge any static electricity. Locate the floppy drive cable and the power cable. Grab both sides of the floppy drive cable and pull it straight back from the motherboard. It should pop off easily, so be sure you don't hit the CRT as you pull it out. The power cable is more difficult to remove, and you need to be extremely careful not to hit the CRT with your hand when the cable disconnects. Take hold of the connector near the motherboard with your left hand and put some additional tension on the cable with your right. Work it slowly and gently until it comes out. Be patient and be careful. Now that the cables are removed, we can take out the motherboard. Pull the motherboard straight up out of the frame. If it sticks, check to make sure something isn't catching against the frame. I'll put the motherboard back in to show you another technique. If you have an upgrade board or high-profile SIMs already installed on the motherboard, pop it out of the guides by inserting the tip of a flat-bladed screwdriver between the frame and the edge of the motherboard and twisting it slightly, like this. I use this method only if the motherboard won't come out normally. Lay the motherboard down on a padded surface with the SIMs facing away from you. Remove all four 256K SIMs. The SIM sockets are arranged in two banks, Bank A and Bank B. Each bank has two sockets. Pick up your 1 megabyte SIMs and insert them into the first bank. Hold the solder edge down. Insert the SIM into the first socket and push it back until it snaps in place. Now do the same thing with the second SIM. You now have two 1 megabyte SIMs in Bank A. Fill the two sockets in Bank B with two of your original 256K SIMs or two more 1 megabyte SIMs. You now have either 2.5 megabytes of memory or 4 megabytes of memory. Look closely at your motherboard and locate resistor R8. Use wire snips to clip one leg of the resistor and then bend it away from the board to prevent contact. Now be careful you don't scratch the motherboard when you clip it. This allows your Plus to recognize the new 1 megabyte SIMs. You're ready to reassemble your computer. Slide the motherboard back into the frame. Connect the power cable. And connect the floppy drive cable. Replace the RF shield, put the case back on, and replace the screws. You're ready to check the memory. Reconnect your mouse, your keyboard, and any other peripherals you have. Plug in your Plus and turn it on. Under the Apple on your screen, select About the Finder. If you've installed 2.5 megabytes of memory, it should read 2,560K for total memory. If you've installed 4 megabytes, it should read 4,096K. If it doesn't, reopen your Mac and make sure that your SIMs are firmly in place. If your Mac still doesn't recognize the new memory, give Mac Technical Support a call at 800-334-4444.
Thanks again for purchasing your SIMs from Mac Connection. We hope this program has made the installation easier for you, and we hope you continue to rely on MacConnection for all your Macintosh computing needs. We'd love to hear what you think of these instructions, and we certainly want to know if we've made any mistakes or were unclear in showing you what to do. We'll look forward to hearing from you.
You should already have the case off your Classic. Touch the metal frame to discharge any static electricity. Look to the side of the CRT, and you'll see the memory upgrade board. Remove it by pulling it straight back away from the motherboard, and then lay it down on a soft surface with the sockets up. Pick up your SIM by the edge of the circuit board. Hold the solder edge down. Insert the SIM into the first socket, and push it back until it snaps in place. I'll do the same thing with the second SIM. Now, locate the jumper on the end of the memory upgrade board. Take it off and move it over one pin. It should cover the second and third pins at the position that reads SIM installed. Reinsert the memory upgrade board and its guides and press it back into the socket on the motherboard. You're ready to reassemble your Classic. Put the case back on and replace the screws. You're ready to check the memory. Reconnect your mouse, your keyboard, and any other peripherals you have. Plug in your Classic and turn it on. Under the Apple on your screen, select About the Finder. Your total memory should now read 4096K. If it doesn't, reopen your Mac and ensure that the memory upgrade board is firmly seated and that the SIMs are firmly in place. If your Mac still doesn't recognize the new memory, give Mac Technical Support a call at 800-334-4444.
Thanks again for purchasing your SIMs from MacConnection. We hope this program has made the installation easier for you, and we hope you continue to rely on MacConnection for all your Macintosh computing needs. We'd love to hear what you think of these instructions, and we certainly want to know if we've made any mistakes or were unclear in showing you what to do. We'll look forward to hearing from you.
You should already have the case off your SE. Touch the metal frame to discharge any static electricity. On the SE, you have either two floppy drive cables or a floppy drive and a hard drive cable. You also have a power cable. First, remove the drive cables. Grab both sides of the floppy drive cable and pull it straight back from the motherboard. Do the same for the other floppy drive or hard drive cable. Both should pop off easily, but be sure you don't hit the CRT as you pull it out. The power cable is more difficult to remove, and you need to be extremely careful not to hit the CRT with your hand when the cable disconnects. Here's what the SE power cables look like. You see the latch on the bottom? One end has to be pressed up so that the other end clears the catch while you pull the connector back. The limited amount of space in here makes it more difficult than it sounds. Put the index finger of your left hand under the latch and press up. Meanwhile, pull the cable back with your right hand. You may want to work it side to side a bit. Be patient and be careful. When the cable disconnects, your hand will have a tendency to bump the video card and the neck of the CRT. Now that the cables are removed, we can take out the motherboard. Look at the bottom of the motherboard and locate the notches in the side that correspond to the tabs on the frame. Now lift the motherboard up until the notches line up with the tabs. Swing the board out slightly until you can see the speaker cable connected to the center of the motherboard. Disconnect the cable, remove the motherboard, and lay it down on a padded surface with the ports facing away from you. There are two main types of SE motherboards, and you have to identify which one you have. Here's how. Look behind the left-hand pair of SIM sockets. If you see a jumper near resistor R35, or on a small daughter board, you have the DIP SIM SE. If there is no jumper, you have the original SE. Now, the installation for each is different. This is the original SE board. There are two banks on an SE motherboard, and each has two SIM sockets. The two rear SIM sockets are bank A, and the two front sockets are bank B. First, remove all four 256K SIMs. Pick up your 1 megabyte SIMs by the circuit board and insert them into bank A. Hold the solder edge down, insert the SIM into the first socket, and push it back until it snaps in place. Do the same thing with the second SIM. You now have two 1 megabyte SIMs in bank A. Fill the two sockets in bank B with two of your original 256K SIMs, or two more 1 megabyte SIMs. You now have either 2.5 megabytes of memory or 4 megabytes of memory. Look closely at your motherboard and locate resistor R35. Use wire snips to clip one leg of the resistor, and then bend it away from the board to prevent contact. Be careful you don't scratch the motherboard when you clip it. This allows your original SE to recognize the new 1 megabyte SIMs. Remember, clipping resistor R35 is only necessary if you have the original SE motherboard. This is the DIP SIM SE motherboard. The SIMs banks are arranged opposite of the original SE board. The two SIM sockets in front are bank A, and the SIM sockets in back are bank B. If you're upgrading to 2.5 megabytes, remove the 256K SIMs from bank A. Replace them with two 1 megabyte SIMs. If you're upgrading to 4 megabytes, remove all 256K SIMs and replace them with four 1 megabyte SIMs. Look closely at your motherboard and locate the jumper. Remove it. It's not necessary to cut a resistor on the DIP SIM board. You're ready to reassemble your computer. Reconnect the speaker cable. Replace the motherboard by setting the left edge in the frame guide. Swing the right side in and set the motherboard down into the frame. Reconnect the power cable. If you have a dual floppy drive SE, connect the floppy drive cable for the top drive in the socket labeled upper drive. Connect the bottom drive cable in the socket labeled lower drive. If you have an SE with an internal hard disk and one floppy drive, connect the floppy drive cable to the lower socket and the hard disk cable to the upper socket. Replace the RF shield, put the case back on, and replace the screws. You're ready to check the memory. Reconnect your mouse, your keyboard, and any other peripherals you have. Plug in your SE and turn it on. Under the Apple on your screen, select About the Finder. If you've installed 2.5 megabytes, it should read 2,560K of total memory. If you've installed 4 megabytes, it should read 4,096K. If it doesn't, reopen your Mac and make sure that your SIMs are firmly in place. If your Mac still doesn't recognize the new memory, give Mac Technical Support a call at 800-334-4444.
Thanks again for purchasing your SIMs from MacConnection. We hope this program has made the installation easier for you, and we hope you continue to rely on MacConnection for all your Macintosh computing needs. We'd love to hear what you think of these instructions, and we certainly want to know if we've made any mistakes or were unclear in showing you what to do. We'll look forward to hearing from you.
You should already have the case off your SE30. Touch the metal frame to discharge any static electricity. Locate the floppy drive cable, the hard drive cable, and the power cable. First, remove the drive cables. Grab both sides of the floppy drive cable and pull it straight back from the motherboard. It should pop off easily, so be sure you don't hit the CRT as you pull it out. Do the same for the hard drive cable. The power cable is more difficult to remove, and you need to be extremely careful not to hit the CRT with your hand when the cable disconnects. Here's what the SE30 power cable looks like. See the latch on the bottom? One end has to be pressed up so that the other end clears the catch while you pull the connector back. The limited amount of space in the Mac makes this more difficult than it sounds. Put the index finger of your left hand under the latch and press up. Meanwhile, pull the cable back with your right hand. Be sure not to rip the ends of the cable out of the connector. You may want to work it side to side a bit. Be patient and careful. When the cable disconnects, your hand will tend to bump the video card and the neck of the CRT, which could cause damage. Now you can take out the motherboard. Look at the bottom of the motherboard and locate the notches in the side that correspond to the tabs on the frame. Lift the motherboard up until the notches line up with the tabs. Swing the board out slightly until you can see the speaker cable connected to the center of the motherboard. Disconnect the cable and remove the motherboard. Lay it down on a padded surface with the ports facing away from you. These are the SIM sockets. They're arranged in two banks of 4 sockets each. These 4 sockets are bank A, and these 4 are bank B. First, remove all 4 256K SIMs from bank A. Pick up your 1 megabyte SIMs by the circuit board and insert them into bank A. Since I'm only installing 4 1-megabyte SIMs, I'll reinstall the original 256K SIMs I removed from Bank A into Bank B. If I were upgrading this Mac to 8 megabytes, I would fill all 8 sockets with 1 megabyte SIMs. You're ready to reassemble your computer. Reconnect the speaker cable. Replace the motherboard by setting the left edge in the frame guide. Swing the right side in and set the motherboard down into the frame. Reconnect the power cable. Reconnect the 2 drive cables. Replace the RF shield. Put the case back on and replace the screws. You're ready to check the memory. Reconnect your mouse, your keyboard, and any other peripherals you have. Plug in your SE30 and turn it on. Under the Apple on your screen, select About the Finder. If you've installed 4 1-megabyte SIMs in addition to the original 4 256K SIMs, the total memory should read 5,120K. If you've installed 8 1-megabyte SIMs, the total memory should read 8,192K. If it doesn't, reopen your Mac and make sure that your SIMs chips are firmly in place. If your Mac still doesn't recognize the new memory, give Mac Technical Support a call at 800-334-4444.
Thanks again for purchasing your SIMs from MacConnection. We hope this program has made the installation easier for you, and we hope you continue to rely on MacConnection for all your Macintosh computing needs. We'd love to hear what you think of these instructions, and we certainly want to know if we've made any mistakes or were unclear in showing you what to do. We'll look forward to hearing from you. Installation of SIMs in the Mac 2 family of computers is very simple, but you need to understand a few things before you begin. First, the 2FX uses 64-pin SIMs instead of the 30-pin SIMs that most other Macs use, so make sure you have the right ones. The two types of SIMs are installed the same way, but they're not interchangeable. Second, the 2FX and the 2CI come in parity and non-parity versions. If you have the parity version, you must use parity SIMs. Count the chips on the SIMs that originally came with your Mac. A non-parity SIM has 8 chips on it, and a parity SIM has 9. The parity versions of the 2FX and 2CI are special order models, so most of you probably have the non-parity version. If you do have a parity version, call Mac Connection Tech Support at 800-334-4444 for further information. We'll start by showing you how to get at the SIM sockets in all the Mac 2 models. The only tool you may need is a Phillips head screwdriver. Here's someone to show you how it's done.
First, disconnect the power cable, the monitor, keyboard, and mouse cables, and any other peripheral cables you have attached to your Mac. Next, open the case. The procedure for all models is basically the same. Remove the screw on the back and lift up the tabs. The tabs on the Mac 2, 2X, and 2FX have to be pushed in first. If you have a Mac 2, 2X, or 2FX, you should see something like this. The SIMs are located below this drive mount platform, so we'll need to take it out. Remove the screw on each corner of the drive mount platform. They're located here. We've already taken them out. The platform is now loose, but it's still connected to the motherboard by the drive and power cables. Remove these cables and put the platform aside. The SIM sockets are now exposed.
If you have a 2CX, 2CI, 2SI, or LC, the SIM sockets are exposed as soon as you open the top, so you're ready for the actual installation. Just fast forward to the appropriate graphic and watch our technical experts walk you through the procedures for your Mac. Remember, if you have a question, give us a call at 800-334-4444 and ask for Mac technical support.
You should have already disconnected your monitor, mouse, and keyboard cables, taken the top off your computer, and removed the drive mount platform. Touch the metal frame to discharge any static electricity. These are the SIM sockets. Bank A consists of these four sockets, and Bank B consists of these four. You want to be sure to put your 1 megabyte or higher SIMs in Bank A. First, remove all four 256K SIMs from Bank A. Next, insert your new 1 megabyte SIMs into Bank A. Remember to handle them by the edges of the circuit board. You now have four 1 megabyte SIMs in Bank A. Now, you can either leave Bank B empty and have just 4 megabytes of memory, or you can reinstall the original 256K SIMs in Bank B for 5 megabytes of memory. Another option is to install 4 1-megabyte SIMs in Bank B for a total of 8 megabytes. Once the SIMs are installed, connect the floppy drive cable. Reconnect the power cable and the hard disk cable, reposition the drive mount platform, and replace the screws. Put the front of the case on first, and then lower the back until it clicks into place. Reconnect your mouse, your keyboard, your monitor, and any other peripherals you have. Boot up the Mac and check Total Memory under About the Finder. If you've upgraded to 4 megabytes, it should read 4,096K. If you reinstalled the original 256K SIMs in addition to the 1 megabyte SIMs, it should read 5,120K. And if you installed 8 megabytes of memory, it should read 8,192K. If it doesn't, reopen your Mac and make sure that your SIMs are firmly in place. If your Mac still doesn't recognize the new memory, give Mac Technical Support a call at 800-334-4444.
Thanks again for purchasing your SIMs from Mac Connection. We hope this program has made the installation easier for you, and we hope you continue to rely on MacConnection for all your Macintosh computing needs. We'd love to hear what you think of these instructions, and we certainly want to know if we've made any mistakes or were unclear in showing you what to do. We'll look forward to hearing from you.
You should have already disconnected the power cable, the monitor, keyboard, and mouse cables, and any other peripheral cables you have attached to your Mac, and taken the top off your 2CX. Touch the metal frame to discharge any static electricity. These are SIM sockets. These four sockets are Bank A, and these four are Bank B. Bank A should always contain the 1 MB SIMs. Remove the original 256K SIMs from Bank A. Next, insert your new 1 MB SIMs in Bank A. Remember to handle them by the edges of the circuit board. Now just reinstall the original 256K SIMs in Bank B. You've now got 5 MB of memory. If you wanted to upgrade to 8 MB, you'd put 4 more 1 MB SIMs in Bank B instead of the 256K SIMs. Put the front of the case on and lower the back until it clicks into place. Reconnect your mouse, your keyboard, your monitor, and any other peripherals you have. Boot up the Mac and check total memory under About the Finder. If you've upgraded to 4 MB, it should read 4096K. If you reinstall the original 256K SIMs in addition to the 1 MB SIMs, it should read 5120K. And if you installed 8 MB of memory, it should read 8192K. If it doesn't, reopen your Mac and make sure your SIMs are firmly in place. If your Mac still doesn't recognize the new memory, give Mac Technical Support a call at 800-334-4444.
Thanks again for purchasing your SIMs from MacConnection. We hope this program has made the installation easier for you, and we hope you continue to rely on MacConnection for all your Macintosh computing needs. We'd love to hear what you think of these instructions, and we certainly want to know if we've made any mistakes or were unclear in showing you what to do. We'll look forward to hearing from you.
You should have already disconnected the power cable, the monitor, keyboard, and mouse cables, and any other peripheral cables you have attached to your Mac, and taken the top off your 2CI. Touch the metal frame to discharge any static electricity. These are the SIM sockets. Now, these four sockets make up Bank A, and these four are Bank B. Placement of your SIMs will depend on whether you're using the built-in video or a new bus video card. If you're using the built-in video, place your 1 megabyte SIMs in Bank B. Leave the 256K SIMs where they are. You now have 5 megabytes of memory, 1 megabyte in Bank A, and 4 megabytes in Bank B. Of course, if you upgraded to 8 megabytes, you would install 1 megabyte SIMs in all 8 sockets. If you're using a new bus video card, you'll get better performance if you put your 1 megabyte SIMs in Bank A. Remove the 256K SIMs from Bank A. Place the 256K SIMs in Bank B and the 1 megabyte SIMs in Bank A. Put the front of the case on and lower the back until it clicks into place. Reconnect the power cable, the monitor, keyboard, and mouse cables, and any other peripheral cables you have attached to your computer. Boot up the Mac and check Total Memory under About the Finder. If you've upgraded to 4 megabytes, it should read 4096K. If you reinstalled the original 256K SIMs in addition to the 1 megabyte SIMs, it should read 5120K. And if you installed 8 megabytes of memory, it should read 8192K. If it doesn't, reopen your Mac and make sure that your SIMs are firmly in place. If your Mac still doesn't recognize the new memory, give Mac Technical Support a call at 800-334-4444.
Thanks again for purchasing your SIMs from MacConnection. We hope this program has made the installation easier for you, and we hope you continue to rely on MacConnection for all your Macintosh computing needs. We'd love to hear what you think of these instructions, and we certainly want to know if we've made any mistakes or were unclear in showing you what to do. We'll look forward to hearing from you.
You should have already disconnected the power cable, the monitor, keyboard, and mouse cables, and any other peripheral cables you have attached to your Mac, and taken the top off your 2SI. Touch the metal frame to discharge any static electricity. One special note, your 2SI will accept 2 megabyte and 4 megabyte SIMs, but you need System 7.0 to recognize the extra memory. We'll use 1 megabyte SIMs for this demonstration. But if you have the 2 or 4 megabyte SIMs, they're installed the same way. This is the only SIM bank on the 2SI, and it has 4 sockets. First, remove the 256K SIMs. Next, insert your new 1 megabyte or higher SIMs. Remember to handle them by the edges of the circuit board. Since your 2SI already has 1 megabyte of memory soldered to the motherboard, you now have 5 megabytes of memory. Put the front of the case on and lower the back until it clicks into place. Reconnect the power cable, the monitor, keyboard, and mouse cables, and any other peripheral cables you have attached to your computer. Boot up the Mac and check Total Memory under About the Finder. It should read 5120K or 8192K. If it doesn't, reopen your Mac and make sure that the SIMs are firmly in place. If your Mac still doesn't recognize the new memory, give Mac Technical Support a call at 800-334-4444.
Thanks again for purchasing your SIMs from Mac Connection. We hope this program has made the installation easier for you, and we hope you continue to rely on Mac Connection for all your Macintosh computing needs. We'd love to hear what you think of these instructions, and we certainly want to know if we've made any mistakes or were unclear in showing you what to do. We'll look forward to hearing from you.
You should have already disconnected the power cable, the monitor, keyboard and mouse cables, and any other peripheral cables you have attached and taken the top off your LC. Touch the metal frame to discharge any static electricity. This is the only SIM bank on the LC. It has two sockets. Since the LC doesn't accept 256K SIMs, the sockets will probably be empty. Just install a 1 MB SIM in each socket. Since your LC already has 2 MB of memory soldered to the motherboard, you now have 4 MB of memory. Put the front of the case on and lower the back until it clicks into place. Reconnect the power cable, the monitor, keyboard, and mouse cables, and any other peripheral cables you have attached. Boot up the Mac and check total memory under About the Finder. If you've upgraded to 4 MB, it should read 4096K. If it doesn't, reopen your Mac and make sure your SIMs are firmly in place. If your Mac still doesn't recognize the new memory, give Mac Technical Support a call at 800-334-4444.
Thanks again for purchasing your SIMs from Mac Connection. We hope this program has made the installation easier for you, and we hope you continue to rely on Mac Connection for all your Macintosh computing needs. We'd love to hear what you think of these instructions, and we certainly want to know if we've made any mistakes or were unclear in showing you what to do. We'll look forward to hearing from you. Upgrading the LaserWriter NTX is very easy. All you'll need is a Phillips head screwdriver. The NTX uses the longer 64-pin SIMs rated at 120 nanoseconds or faster. Since the 30-pin SIMs used on most Macs won't fit in a 64-pin SIM socket, be sure you have the right SIMs before you start. Here's someone to show you how it's done.
First, let's remove the AppleTalk connector and power cable from the back. Next, remove the two screws that secure the interface board. Pull the board straight back and out. These are the three memory banks. This is Bank 0, Bank 1, and Bank 2. Each bank has 4 SIM sockets. This NTX has 4 256K SIMs installed in Bank 0 and 4 more in Bank 1 for a total of 2 MB of memory. On the NTX, always fill Bank 0 with SIMs that contain the most memory. If Bank 1 is used, it should contain SIMs equal to or smaller than Bank 0. And if Bank 2 is used, it should contain SIMs equal to or smaller than Bank 1. I'm going to remove the 256K SIMs from Bank 0 and replace them with the new 1 megabyte SIMs for a total of 5 megabytes. This chart shows the possible memory configurations for the NTX. As you can see, although there are several possible memory configurations, 6 megabytes is not one of them. Reinsert the interface board and replace the screws. Reconnect the power cable and the network interface box and power up the printer. Once it warms up, it should print out a test page with the total memory installed on the printer at the bottom of the page. This printer was upgraded to 5 megabytes, so the test page reads 5 megabytes. If yours doesn't, give Mac Technical Support a call at 800-334-4444.
Thanks again for purchasing your SIMs from MacConnection. We hope this program has made the installation easier for you, and we hope you continue to rely on MacConnection for all your Macintosh computing needs. We'd love to hear what you think of these instructions, and we certainly want to know if we've made any mistakes or were unclear in showing you what to do. We'll look forward to hearing from you. The portable isn't SIM-based, but its memory can be upgraded by installing a card into an expansion slot on the motherboard. There are several manufacturers who make memory upgrade cards for the portable, and the amount of memory the card can hold and the way it's upgraded varies considerably from one manufacturer to the next. The original Apple card was a non-upgradable 1 megabyte card. The chips were soldered directly to the board, and there were no sockets to add additional memory. The new Apple card can be upgraded in 1 megabyte increments to 4 megabytes of memory. This demonstration will show you how to upgrade a portable using Apple's original expansion card. Remember, the RAM disk will be erased during the installation process. If you use a RAM disk, be sure to save its contents to the hard disk before you begin the installation. It's time for some real work, so I'll get my assistant.
Close the portable and disconnect the peripheral cables. Remove the rear cover. Press the two buttons on the back side of the case, pull up, back first, and lift the cover away from the Mac. Touch something metal to discharge static electricity. You should see something like this. This is the hard drive. These are the expansion sockets, and this is the housing for the battery. Go ahead and remove the battery. The battery cover lifts off this way, and the battery lifts straight out. It's heavier than it looks, so be careful not to drop it. Replace the battery cover over the empty housing to prevent the Mac from trying to run off the 9-volt battery. Okay, we're ready to install the card. The large black connector next to the hard drive is the processor direct slot. The black connector next to that is the memory expansion slot. It's labeled J11. Position the card over the connector. The large end goes toward the back. Be sure that the hard disk and floppy drive cables don't interfere with the card. Once you're sure the card is aligned properly, press down on it until it's seated in the socket. After the card's in place, remove the battery cover, replace the battery, and put the battery cover back on. Replace the case and open the Mac. Under About the Finder, you should see 2048K for total memory. If you've saved the contents of a RAM disk to the hard disk, you'll want to be sure to copy that back again. For specific information on how to upgrade the memory of your particular expansion card, refer to the instructions that came with the product or give us a call. If you have problems or questions concerning a particular type of portable upgrade board, give Mac Technical Support a call at 800-334-4444.
Thanks again for purchasing your SIMS from MacConnection. We hope this program has made the installation easier for you, and we hope you continue to rely on MacConnection for all your Macintosh computing needs. We'd love to hear what you think of these instructions, and we certainly want to know if we've made any mistakes or were unclear in showing you what to do. We'll look forward to hearing from you.